He's scared his voice may not return. Scared he won't be able to walk. Scared he won't be able to move his arms. Scared that the real world is a world of fear. At least his throat doesn't hurt anymore, and the headaches seem to be a thing of the past. Each day, he spends hours in an exercise room, seemingly designed to build his frustration more than his muscles, despite the posters of cats and dogs offering slogans of encouragement. He works at lifting his own body weight, first his arms, then his legs, each one weighing a ton, each one impossible until it isn't. The isn't coming 8 days after leaving Coma World. And when it does come, it comes quickly. One day he can barely lift his arms off the table, the next he's got them in the air above his body. Soon he can keep them raised for 20 seconds, for 30, for a minute, which gives him more privacy in the bathroom as he can clean himself up. It takes a few more days for the same to be true for his legs, but eventually he realises that the cats and dogs of the therapy room posters are right. He can hang in there. He can be positive. He can be pawsome. Even so, no number of cats and dogs can stop him from thinking about his parents. What's the point of building his muscles back when his heart has been ripped out? At night, he cries himself to sleep. Other than Hazel, the only people who come to visit are his grandparents, his dad's parents. His other grandparents aren't around, one having died and the other in a home with dementia.